Hello, my name is Tracy. This video is my final assessment for my level 1 teacher course that I've been studying through My Health Yoga. I hope you enjoy. Come to your mat, take a comfortable seated position, your legs crossed or in front of each other. Use this time so we can focus our awareness on the sensations within. Practice pratyahara, withdrawal of the senses, and bring your attention to what is happening inside of your body. This comfortable sitting pose promotes groundedness and inner calm. If at any time you need to just bring yourself back to calm, you need to steady yourself, just take a seat and sit down. Close your eyes. In this state of this pose, it becomes serene, tranquil, and we can reduce our anxiety. Close down your eyes. Bring your hands to your knees. If you feel the need for higher energy, place your hands palm up. If you need to be grounded, place them palm down. We're going to move now to the Maharaja Pranayama, full yogic breath. This is a practice where we fill the lungs completely to generate an all-important supply of oxygen to the cell. This practice helps to soothe the nervous system and recharges us with prana, our vital life force energy. To do this practice, we simply fill the entire lungs, so from the belly, the chest, and the collarbones. With each breath, we have a full expansion. With each exhale, we completely empty out our lungs. I'll lead you through this, and then we will do a few more in your own time. Exhaling from wherever you are. Take a big breath in and inhale. Fill the lower belly, expanded like a balloon, up into the chest and right up into the collarbone. As you exhale, empty from the collarbone first, the chest, and the lower belly, and draw back that navel to the spine to empty out completely. Inhaling, expanding through the lower belly, the middle belly, and up into the upper chest. Exhale, releasing from the collarbones, the chest, and the lower belly. Let's do three more of these in your own time. Inhale. When you've completed your next round of breath, just return to a normal breath. Keep your awareness inward and keep that focus on the breath. Now come with me. In your next inhale, slowly open the eyes. I'm going to move into a gentle warm-up for the lower back, upper back, and our arms. Follow me as we lead this through with our breath and stretch out. Inhale, take your interlace your fingers up to your chin, look up. Exhale, let's push away and curl the back. Inhale, take your arms up and overhead and expand through the chest. Exhale, take your hands around to the back and interlace your fingers and extend out.
Exhale, fold forward and raise the arms. Inhale, release the arms.
Come back. Exhale to prepare. Inhale, back. Exhale, push away. Inhale, come up and expand. Exhale, take them round to the back, interlace them. Extend those arms to the exhale. Inhale, once more.
Exhale, let's fold forward, taking those arms a little bit higher this time.
Inhale to come up. Exhale, release. Last time. Inhale, up. Exhale, expand away. Inhale, open that chest. Exhale, take the arms around to the back, stretch them out. Inhale, expand and open the chest.
Exhale, fold forward and raise the arms.
Inhale, to come up and release. Well done. We're going to move now to Dandasana, Star Pose. Take your legs out in front. Adjust your weight, put your gently on both sitting bones. We're pulling the flesh away from those bones. Take your legs out and strong. Bring your toes back as they flex back towards you. Engage the thighs. Work on getting those kneecaps down to the floor. Extend up through the spine. Pull back your shoulders and take your hands to the floor. Dandasana, the staff pose. Imagine the staff is at the vertical core of your torso, firmly rooted to the earth, the support and pivot of all that you do. This pose works to strengthen the back, stretches the shoulders and the chest, and improves our posture. Excellent. Okay, release the arms, release the legs. Now take your right leg in. Bring the sole of the foot to the floor and as close to your groin as you can. Inhale and extend up through the spine. Exhale, let's wrap this left arm around our leg and take our right arm back and around to the floor behind us. Sit up tall and face the front. Inhale, let's extend once more. Exhale, let's turn and look over that right shoulder. Giving ourselves a nice twist. Bringing out the toxins, helping our digestive system. Take one last breath here. Inhale. Exhale, come back around to the front. Release the leg. Adjust your sitting bones if necessary. Let's bring our left leg in now. Touching our thighs as close to our groin as we can. Sitting up nice and tall. Inhale, let's wrap that right arm around the left leg. Exhale, let's take the other arm round to the floor behind us. Sitting up tall, inhale to extend the spine. And exhale, twist and look over your left shoulder. Pose aids in digestion. Brings a gentle massage to your abdominal organs. Helps the spine. Make sure that that extended leg stays strong and those toes are flexed back towards you. Take one last breath here. Inhale. Exhale, come back around to the front. I'm going to move now into a cat and cow pose. Come to all fours. Your hands and your wrists should be directly underneath your shoulders. Your knees directly underneath your hips. Your knees are hip width apart and your wrists are shoulder width apart. Take a look down between your legs. Just make sure that you cannot see your big toes so that your feet are still aligned and parallel to your knees. Keep a nice comfortable flat back position as we prepare. Taking a big breath, let's inhale, drop the belly, point the tail away and look up. Exhale to curl, taking the spine up towards the ceiling. drawing the navel in. Inhale, lower the belly, look up. Exhale, take it away. Stretch it out and push away with your hands, taking your spine up. Cat and cow combination, gently awakens our spine, prepares us for the practice ahead of us. And you inhale, open your heart, lift it up. Exhale, just release anything that no longer serves you. And come back to a seated position. Tucking your toes under, prepare, we're going to move up into downward facing dog. Inhale, engage the abdominals, draw up the bundes, and exhale, let's raise the tail to the sky. Extend out through the arms. Push up with the legs. Push up with the arms. Make your tail as high as you can. Downward facing dog pose is a great resting pose. Stretches out the arm meridians for heart and lung health. It also elongates the leg meridians to help with detoxification and fluid, removal of excess fluid in our body. Draw up Mulabandha so that you can get that tail that little bit higher. Your heels may not come down to the ground yet because you haven't quite warmed up. But with every exhale, just see if you can work them down closer to the mat, getting those legs straighter with each and every breath. Inhale, look up between your hands. Exhale, let's bring that leg forward. Particularly bring it if you need to. We're going to drop that right leg onto the floor, the knee, and flatten out the feet. Take a breath in. Come up to your knee. If you're comfortable and balanced in this position, bring your hands to your heart center. A beautiful low lunge position. Stretches out. Front of the right thigh, gentle back bend as we open up and warm up the body in preparation. Take one more breath here. Exhale, release your hands down, draw the left leg back, and then bring the right foot forward, making sure that your knee is directly over your ankle. Slide your left leg back as far as you can so there's no discomfort in the kneecap. Find your point, your drishti on the floor, and when you're balanced, come up, bring your hands to Anjali Mudra, heart center. Feeling that lovely stretch along the left thigh. The gentle arch to the back as we stack our torso over our hips. One last breath in. Exhale. Curl the toes of the left leg up. Lift it up. So extend out through the back leg. Prepare. Bring the left leg through to match the right. Toes touching. Heels 2 or 3 centimeters apart. Inhale. Extend and straighten the back. Exhale. Let's go into Uttanasana. Forward fold. Extend out through the backs of the legs. Drawing the bundes. Pull that navel back to the spine to allow you to fold even further. With every exhale, take your nose a little bit closer to your knees. Feel a lovely stretch on the backs of the legs. Inhale to prepare. Exhale, hold that deeper one last time. On your next inhale, come up to standing, take your arms up to the sky. Exhale, bring your hands back down through the center line to your heart center. Prepare now, let's move into Surya Namaskare, Sun Salutation. Before we do that, just take a moment in Samasthiti to align ourselves correctly. Make sure your big toes are touching. Your heels are 2 or 3 centimeters apart. Your pelvis is slightly tucked so that your tailbone points down towards the earth. Engage your thighs, draw your kneecaps up, and your hands to your heart center. Feel the ground, feel the power of the energy coming up from the earth, illuminating all of the chakras from the root or base chakra right through to the crown. This is a powerful pose, energizes your body, prepares you. As we move in now to our sun salutation. Inhale, take the arms up, look up, bend your back. Exhale, fold forward, Uttanasana. Inhale, look up, Adho Uttanasana. Exhale, take the left leg back into a lunge and flatten your hands. Inhale, take the right leg back and come into plank. Prepare. Exhale, lower down to Chaturanga Dandasana. Flatten out the feet and come up into upward facing dog. Curl under the toes, push up as we exhale back into downward facing dog. Take a moment here to check back in with your breath. Also check with your alignment. Your feet should be hip width apart, the toes slightly towards each other. See if you can extend out through those legs, extending out through the arms, and looking back up between your legs if your neck is okay. Take a moment here, take a few breaths. Check back in with your breath as we did in the beginning of our practice. Take one more breath here. And as you inhale, look forward between your hands. Bring your left leg forward into your lunge. Exhale, let's bring that right leg forward, toes touching. Looking up. Exhale, folding forward into Uttanasana. Inhale, take your arms out wide and up to the sky, looking up. Exhale, bringing back down to the center line. Let's keep this flowing on the other side. Inhale, taking your arms up and overhead, gently stretch the back. Exhale, fold forward, keeping that extension, Uttanasana, fold forward. Exhale, look up. The right leg back, keeping it flattening your hands. Inhale, take that left leg back, you come into plank. Prepare. Exhale, let's lower down, flatten out the toes, push up into upward facing dog. Curl under the toes, push back up, as you exhale, to downward facing dog. Take a few breaths here to rest, calm the breath, calm the mind, spread out through the fingers, spread out through the toes, extend the spine. One more breath. Inhale, look forward between your hands. Exhale, bring that right leg forward if you need to help it along. Looking forward. Exhale, let's bring the other foot back. Toes touching. Feel two fingers, feel centimeters apart. Arch your back, look up. And exhale, fold forward into Uttanasana. Inhale, take the arms up and overhead. Exhale, bring them back down. Just your center line. Stopping. I'm Anjali Mudra, heart center. Time to take your hands down into Tadasana, mountain pose. Calm the breath, but at the same time, still feeling that energy coming up through the earth, giving you lightness, giving you the vital force energy we call prana. Spread out through the fingers. Keep your spine long. Draw up your quadriceps and tuck under that pelvis. With your next inhale, lift your left leg and take it back out wide on the mat. You want to come to a heel to arch alignment. So the heel of the front foot intersects the arch of the back foot. Check your width, check your distance. Your distance should be approximately one of your leg lengths long. Or if you take your arms out, it should be no wider than your wrist. Inhale, take those arms out at shoulder height. Square off the hips to the front of the mat, to the side of the mat. Prepare. Exhale, let's fold and bend with that front knee. And take your gaze up and over your extended arm. Virabhadrasana 2 or Warrior 2 is this pose. Metaphysically, it gives us purpose in life. Taking your gaze over your index finger, you can see where you're headed. This pose also stimulates the bladder, spleen, and stomach meridians to help you with digestion and fluid. Inhale, straighten the leg, take the arms down, and take them to your hips. Turn the right foot forward 90 degrees, and taking the left foot out. Maintaining our heel to arch alignment, and our hips square to the side of the mat. Inhale, arms up, exhale, bend through that front knee. This time, take a glance down, make sure that you can't see your big toe, so that you just see your big toe, so that you're working on turning and opening up through this front leg. Your arms are at shoulder width, the height, just make sure to drop them down, take them away from your ears. This pose teaches stamina and concentration. It's a strong pose, working all parts of our body. Become the warrior. The strength is within you. One last breath, feel that strength. Inhale, exhale, release the arms. This time we're going to turn the feet back around, facing the opposite direction. Still squaring your hips up to the long side of the mat, taking your arms out, move into Trikonasana, triangle pose. Extend up and out with that front arm and then turn like a windmill, keeping your arms up and in a lovely triangle shape. If your neck is okay, turn your head to look up. Your bottom hand can rest on your shin or the floor or wherever it falls for you today. The most important thing is we align our body as though it's between two planes of glass, opening up the chest and expanding out through the arms. Triangle pose opens up the meridians on all meridians. Allow the free flow of energy throughout our body. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, let's give those arms a break. Turn the feet back around, moving to the other side, still maintaining our heel to arch alignment and our hips square to the front. Take up your arms, prepare, lean over, and extend out as you turn. Look up to extended arm. Pose stretching our legs, opening our chest. Great to help with the menopausal symptoms. Strong pose. Inhale. And exhale, up. Release the arms and take them back to your hips. This time, I'd like you to turn your toes slightly inward, keeping your legs still nice and wide, the toes slightly inward. Tuck under that pelvis so we're not moving too far forward. Lengthen the spine. Arch your back and look up. And keeping that extension, lead with the chin. You should come down to pause at 90 degrees. Engage the bundles, draw up, draw that navel to the spine to support you. When you're ready, exhale, let's fold a little bit further forward. Taking your hands to your mat if you are able. If you can, reach the mat with your fingers. Try to flatten out the hands at shoulder width apart and ensure that they are in line with your toes, so your fingertips and your toes are in one line. Tuck your elbows under,
Inhale, extend that spine. And exhale, let's just fold that little bit deeper. Metaphysically, this pose literally turns our world upside down, gives us a new perspective on life. Enjoy it. At the same time, feel the lovely extension through the backs of the legs, the release in the hamstrings. Take one last breath here.
Push back up to your fingertips. Now I'd like you to take your left hand directly underneath your face, flat, palm flat on the floor. Take your right hand to your hips as we take this into a twist. Inhale to maintain the extension in the spine. Exhale, let's twist and look up towards the ceiling. If your neck is okay, extend up through that right arm and look out at the fingers and what lies beyond. Inhale one more time. Exhale, let's swap those hands over, taking the right hand directly underneath the face and the left hand to the hip. Drawing in, engaging the wonders. As you exhale, let's twist and turn to look up. If your neck is okay, extend out through the arm, maintaining a lovely twist and also a great extension through the arms and shoulders. One last breath. Exhale, release the hands to the floor. Take them to your hips. Engage the abdominals and using your core strength. And back up to standing. I'm going to move now into a balanced pose, Vikasana, tree pose. Let's just find our center of gravity on the mat before we begin. Placing your hands on your hips, just lift your toes and rock forward, rock back. Take your weight to the left and weight to the right and find a neutral position where you feel balanced. Now move away from this neutral position to bring your weight on the left foot. Spread out through the toes and place them back down on the mat. Slowly lift off your right foot from the ground so that you can feel that your weight is in that left foot. You can balance your right foot against your leg here. Or if you're feeling steady, take it to the calf. If you're ready to go that little bit further with me today, take the knee up, foot up and place it on the inner thigh. Paying attention to turn out that knee to the side. Find your balance, focus your drishti, your gaze point, on the floor in front of you and something that isn't moving. When you're balanced, centered and grounded, bring your hands up to your heart center. It's okay to sway like a tree. The freedom to move while staying firmly rooted helps you find balance in all things. If you want to take this a little bit deeper, open your arms up wide to the sky. Take your forefinger and your first finger. Throw your thumb and first finger into a chin mudra and make an O. This maintains the flow of prana, energy or vital life force throughout the body. Make sure you draw your shoulders away, up and down, away from your ears. Take one last breath in this lovely balanced pose. Exhale, release the arms. Bring the knee up, release the leg and shake it out. Moving our weight now onto our right foot. Spread out through the toes of the right foot. Bring your left foot just to rest on the bottom of your shin. If you're finding balance there, you can move your foot to your calf. Or if you're coming with me today, grab a hold and bring it up to your inner thigh. making sure this foot leg is open to the wide, to the side. And you're balanced, centered, and grounded. Bring your hands to your heart center. Remember, it's easier to keep your balance if you focus your drishti on something that isn't moving. Open wide to the sky, taking your fingers to chin mudra, looking for growth, light, and universal energy as we feel the prana come up through the earth, illuminating the chakras, giving us lightness. One last breath in, release the arms, bring the leg around to the front, release the leg. Well done. We're going to move now into a squat, not a pose. So just take your feet, not too far, just a little wider than hip width apart. Turn your feet away from you, and your heels towards you. Using your abdominals, just slowly lower ourselves down to a comfortable squat. You may need to adjust yourself to where you are comfortable on the mat. Using your elbows, take them into your knees, bringing your hands to your heart center. Maintain the length in the back. Using your elbows, just gently push out through those knees. Malasana, a garland pose. It's a wonderful hip opening pose. It also improves our balance and coordination. In this pose, we are opening the hips, the groin, and the inner thighs. At the same time, we are stretching our ankles and feet. I recommend this pose to anyone who has lower back tension. It's also a really good prenatal exercise to prepare the body for birth. It's a strong pose. You will feel a stretch in your inner thighs. You will feel your feet working hard here. It's become a very nice, calm place to squat the 6th of September. Well done. Let's come out of this pose now. So we move into camel. So take your knees down to the mat. Ensure that your feet and knees are parallel, that your knees are hip width apart. Come up onto your knees. Slightly rotate your pelvis. A slight tuck under so that you maintain your lower spine pointing to the earth. Ustrasana, or camel pose, beautiful heart opening pose. It can improve anxiety, fatigue. It also helps us with our respiratory conditions. I like this pose because metaphysically it helps you to find compassion and to express your feelings openly and honestly with others. Taking your hands now to your lower back or your upper buttocks, you can start in this position. Take a big breath in, expand and open the chest, and look up as you gently arch the back. This may be where you are today, and that's okay. This is a strong pose for many people. You should not feel any compression in the lower back. If you do, then slightly bring your neck forward and come slightly back up. It will take some time for your back to release and to let go and to bring movement back, especially if you haven't been practicing for quite some time. If you are comfortable in this position and you want to take it a little bit further, you can move your hands down to your thighs, your lower thighs, the upper thighs, or even reach down to each foot. If not, leave your hands to lower back and enjoy the benefits of the camel pose. Take one last breath here. Straighten the back and come up. As a counterbalance for this pose, let's move into Balasana, or child's pose. Balasana is a beautiful resting pose. Calms the brain and the nervous system. Bringing your knees together, your feet together. Take your bottom back to your heels. Sit up tall. Extend out through the spine. Inhale. Exhale. Let's fold forward, taking our third eye or our forehead to the mat. And releasing our arms along our sides, also to the mat, palms facing up. You can take a hold of your feet if you like to encourage the flow of prana continue throughout your body. Close down your eyes and bring your attention back to the breath. Focus inwards. Breathe in through and out through the nose. Calm your breath and calm your mind. This pose also helps with anxiety, stress, and depression. If at any time throughout your practice you feel you need to take a break, you can come back to this pose. Helps you refresh. Also extends out the meridian, and that's all sorts of benefits. Gently massages our abdominal organs as our tummy rests on our legs. One last breath here. Open your eyes. Inhale. Sit up. Sitting up tall. While we're in this pose, let's move into another pose, hero pose. So coming back up to your knees. Reach down. You take your knees together and your ankles are a little bit wider. Grab your calves and turn them and open them outwards. And then gently see if you can lower your bottom to the mat. This pose invigorates the legs. It's great after a long day of standing on your feet at work. If you're finding discomfort, you can place a block or a pillow under your bottom at a little bit more height, a little bit less stress on your knees. Should you feel any pain or discomfort in this position? If you are, come back up and return to Balasana, child's pose, as we just did before. Inhale, back up, release the legs, cross the legs over, bring your hands down, press them over and come back up to sit onto your bottom. Readjust yourself on your mat. You're going to move into bridge pose. Bridge pose helps all kinds of digestive issues, stretches the ren, the stomach, spleen, meridians of the front of the body. So do this, lower yourself vertebra by vertebra down into the mat. Place your hands on the floor and bring your knees, bend your knees up and bring your feet closer to your body. Bring your heels as far in as they are, just so that your fingertips are grazing the back of your heels. Slightly turn your toes towards each other. Make sure that your neck is long, your spine is long. Inhale to prepare. And exhale, let's lift our bottom up, coming up, pushing up to the sky, making sure those knees don't come apart. The gentle back bend opens up and stretches the whole front of the front torso. Make sure the knees are coming, work towards pressing those knees together. Feeling a lovely stretch. Inhale, exhale, let's roll that spine back down to the floor as we release. Let's move into the second version of this pose, the bridge pose. Inhale, prepare.
Exhale, let's curl that bottom off the floor. And if you can, interlace your fingers underneath your bottom, so along the mat, and stretch those arms out long. Use that strength there in your arms. Stretch them out. Make sure your knees aren't splaying out, so keep using those muscles to keep that hip towards the ceiling in a gentle inversion. This pose is also good to stimulate the thyroid. Take one last breath here. Exhale, release, let it down. I'm going to take the final version here and a more advanced version. If you feel you're not ready to take this level, please stick with the first or second version that we've just done. For those of you who are working a little bit deeper today, inhale to prepare. Exhale, curl that tail up to the sky. Take the shoulders and roll the shoulders under. And using your hands, just take them to your lower back, your hips, to help work those hips up higher. Giving a lovely stretch, stimulating that thyroid, giving us all the benefits of a back bend. Take one last breath here. Inhale, exhale, let's roll down. Bring your knees in towards your belly. Gently rock from side to side, massaging the lower back. Stretch this down with the counterbalance that back bends we've just done. Take your feet back on the mat. This time just rotate the pelvis, so draw it down. But you can feel the back flatten out against the mat, reducing the gap underneath your spine. Inhale, release. Exhale, take it here again. Inhale, release. Exhale, last time. Take it there and just hold it there. Draw that navel back to the spine, releasing any tension that you have there. Inhale, well done. Crossing over your legs, grab a hold of your feet. And we'll just do a gentle rock to come up to sitting. Taking your feet over your head, rock up, sitting. Bringing your knees back on the mat. Let's move into boat pose or Navasana. It's a strong pose working your core. You can support this by engaging and drawing up through the bundas. This pose strengthens our abdominals, our hip flexors, and our spine. Inhale to prepare. Exhale, just bring your weight back onto your sitting bones, gently lifting your feet off the floor. You might want to stay here. That's where you are today. If you want to take this a little bit further, extend out through the arms and lift up the legs. This pose helps us develop focus and concentration. Also stimulates the kidneys and the thyroid. Inhale. Exhale, release. Bring your feet now together, soles together, legs wide apart. Hold on to your ankles or your feet wherever you can. Just adjust yourself on your sitting bones so that you can get the most extension out of your spine. Inhale to prepare and extend the spine. Exhale, let's fold a little bit forward and just use the weight of our elbows to just gently help to open up those legs. Up those hips. Baddha Konasana, bound angle or butterfly pose, stimulates the abdominal organs, alleviates fatigue, relieves sciatica, metaphysically an opening of this groin area helps us to release emotional guilt and sexual inhibitions. You should feel a beautiful stretch in your inner thighs and your hips. Keeping that back long. Well done.
Take the knees back up together. Using your abdominals again. Let's gently lower ourselves to the ground. Move into another gentle hip opening pose. Bringing your knees up to your chest. And then take your feet up so that they're parallel to the ceiling. Grab a hold of your feet with your hands. Come out. Take your knees wide under your armpits. Your legs open. Happy baby pose. Reconnect here with your inner child. You may find you like to just gently rock from side to side as you just bring your own entrance. Hip opener again. Successive groin. Work and resist. So push away with your feet while also pulling with your hands to get the most out of this pose. So work on resistance as we enjoy and remember our happy days. Beautiful. Bring the knees together and release and just hug them in. Nice stretch. Extension through our spine. Lift your head up and lower it down, making sure that your neck is nice and long, so is your spine. This time take your arms out at shoulder height. Keep your knees towards your chest. Inhale to prepare. And exhale, let's take those knees over to our left side. And if your head's okay, turn to look over to the right. Make sure your shoulders are still down, firmly grounded on the earth. You're comfortable in this spinal twist. The twist helps us detoxify the liver, literally wring the toxins out of our body. It's a beautiful way to prepare our spine for our final poses. Great way to unwind at the end of the day. Inhale, using your abdominals, draw those knees back up to the center. Hug them back in, lift your head up towards your knees, and then lower it back down to make sure we still maintain that spinal extension. Taking your arms back out. Inhale to prepare. Exhale, let's take the legs over to the right. And if your neck is okay, take your gaze over to your left. This pose eases back and neck tension, soothes the overactive nervous system. Beautiful cleansing, but also relaxing pose. Inhale, bring those legs back up and hug them in. Gently rock, take the knees a little wider, gently massage the floor spine. Keep the knees together now, just working the figure of eight. We've worked on our lower back today, we've worked on our arms and shoulders, opened up meridian chakras. And now we need to prepare for our final pose. Shavasana. Extend one leg out at a time along the mat. Let your feet lay out to the sides. Let your shoulders rest on the mat. Take your arms out about 45 degrees from your body, palms facing up. Close down your eyes. Bring your awareness back within your body and focus on your breath. Just as we did at the beginning of the class, let's do three rounds of the Maharaja Pranayama, the full yogic breath. Exhale from wherever you are. Inhale, draw the air in, filling up your belly, your chest, and right up into the collarbone.
Exhale, release from the chest, navel, and right into the lower belly. In your own time, complete this two more rounds. When you've finished your second round, return to a normal breath. Shavasana, one of the most important poses you'll do today. It helps let your body reap the benefits of our practice. It helps to regulate your blood pressure. It helps to calm the mind, the nervous system. Slow the breath, provide us with deep relaxation. Bring your awareness to your third eye center and concentrate on your breath. Let the thoughts of the day behind you leave your mind, and let the day ahead of you leave them away. Focus your mind as it wanders back on your breath. Follow that breath as you inhale it through the nose and fill your lungs. And you exhale it out through the nose. Lovely, feeling breath. Slowly and very gently bring your awareness back to the room around you, to the weight of your body on the mat beneath you. Feel the support of the earth. Feel the calmness of the mind. Gently start to reawaken the body. Wiggle your fingers. Wiggle your toes. Gently rock your head from side to side on the mat. With your next inhale. Extend up the arms up and over your head. Stretch out from the fingertips out through the toes. Stretch your entire body. Take a few breaths and stretch. Exhale, draw the knees up and into the chest. Gently rock side to side, massaging the lower back. Keeping your eyes closed and your attention on your breath. Roll now onto your right side as we pause. Let our body adjust. Take a few breaths here. Keep your eyes closed. Using your hands to prop you up. Come up into a comfortable cross-legged seated position on the mat. Keep your eyes closed. Take your hands down to your knees. Put them palm down before we move. Get ready to start our day again with just have this final few minutes of peace to allow your mind and your body to feel peace within. Breathe in new life, new experiences, love, and everything that is wonderful. With every exhale, just release and let go of anything at all still remains and it does not serve your highest good. Any time in your life when you're stressed, back to the seated position. Calm your mind, calm your body. Breathe in the life, breathe out everything you no longer need. Finish the class. I'd like to leave a chant of the word Om, or Aum, as you may know it. Om is the sound that vibrates in the universe. Chanting this sound helps to bring peace and calm to the body, mind and soul, by merging the vibrations of the body with that of the universe. To chant, we inhale deeply. And on our exhale, for about 80% of our breath, make the sound, oh. And for the final 20% of our breath, the sound, If you'd like to come with me, we're going to chant Om three times to seal the class. Inhale. Joy and love. Namaste.